This is Pastor David Donovan. I want to show you beyond a shadow of a doubt that the Columbia space shuttle disaster, the Challenger space shuttle disaster, and the Apollo 1 space shuttle disaster, where we lost 17 astronauts, it is the judgment of God on the nation, and it's a sign of what's yet to come. Let's look at the center of this thing. What we have here is the Texas license plate that was on cars in Texas when Columbia passed over Fort Worth, Texas, and blew up. These tags, let me just read it. This license plate was introduced in 2000, and 31.5 million sets of these plates were manufactured before a new general issue plate was launched in 2009. These plates represent the last of a Texan era. The design has the distinction of being last stamp plate in Texas history, and also the last general issue plate issued with six characters. The design of this plate features a little bit of everything, including a space shuttle, oil derrick, and cowboy on a horse when it was launched in 2000. It doesn't tell you the crescent moon, but it's up there on the right. It became the first Texas plate to use three colors, blue, red, and black. Now, here's not a very well-known fact. All three of the disasters where we lost 17 men, the one in 67, 86, and 03, a 36-year period, all happened in the same six-day period every single time during the year. And that six-day period is between January 27th and February 1st. All the disasters happened within that time period. Now, I'm not a rocket scientist or big on math, but when you're talking about the possibility of that happening like that, that's very astronomical. 1 to the 12th to the 13th hundred power, something just astronomical for this to happen. Now, this particular plate on here that you're looking at, it says that it came out, it was introduced in 2000. I had not had one of those plates yet, so it was really new, even though it shows, it says, it gives the number of those multiple sets of plates that had been manufactured before the general use plate was launched in 2009. But when the shuttle Columbia exploded, I didn't have one of these plates on dump truck, trucks, cars, anything around the ministry work that we were doing. It didn't stand out to me. But when the explosion happened, even the national news, ABC, NBC, CBS, were going, wow, man, isn't this incredible? Look at this. And they didn't use the word incredible. They said, this is really eerie. That's the way the world looks at this kind of stuff. Here's the shuttle up in the stars going over the cowboy in Texas with the crescent moon and the oil rigs. And when an explosion happens, it's 9 o'clock in the morning when this goes down. Now, but remember that all 17 astronauts that died in the same six-day period, all three shuttles, Apollo 1, Challenger, and Columbia, which, by the way, Columbia, it means like Columbia, Washington, D.C., all happened in the same six-day period between the 27th of January and the 1st of February. And there's a reason for this, and there's a reason that the last one blew up in Texas, over Fort Worth, Texas, because the Lord is speaking loud and clear to the nation, everybody that will listen, that he's doing it, that this is a sign of the destruction that is yet to come to the nation. Now, as we go through the rest of this video, I will read out to you dreams and things that have been dated that will bring all this together. Now I want to look below there, right below that, where it says Zola Levitt. Zola Levitt, who many of us have watched for years and years and years, and learned a lot about the Word of God from Zola's ministry, he became sick and got out of the hospital after they didn't think he was coming out of the hospital. And when he got out of the hospital, A little further down the road, Zola got sick, went in the hospital and died. And everybody was going, we thought he was going to die the last time. And all of a sudden, he was gone. Everybody's going, wow, this is really strange the way this happened. One of the things that we're going to get into is that Zola went to bless the Columbia Space Shuttle, Columbia, Washington, D.C. And he preached a sermon there. But this video is going to show you that God had cursed that. That shuttle was coming down just like the other two had because of a passage in the Bible and by many of the prophets. You find it in Jeremiah where the Lord tells the high and haughty nation when he's going to destroy it, when he's going to destroy Babylon, destroy Jerusalem. Even if you exalt your nest into the heavens, I will bring you down from your lofty perch. Okay? And what we're tying together here, we're tying together that verse with the horse and the rider are thrown into the sea. The enemies of Israel, that they will chase Israel down to destroy them, but God will destroy them in the process. And there's a lot of issues into this. I'll try to stay specifically focused on these two events. But Bill Clinton and Oslo, that was the turning point for America. That's when the judgment was set. The judgment was set that there was no turning back when Rabin was assassinated. If you go to the website, YouTube, See This Dreamer Cometh, you'll find more videos with dates and places and things that will explain that more. But that Zola Levitt, just as Bill Clinton got Rabin, the apple of God's eye, the prime minister, give that land away, God killed him. God let him die. God lifted his hand, stretched his hand out, and Rabin was dead for giving that land away, making that deal. Zola, when Zola went to bless the space shuttle, he was going against the will of God. And this is why he lost his life. I'm not saying that he's not in heaven. But what God has given me through dreams and visions in the Word of God is that he was an example that God took him home because he wasn't listening to him. And we can find that example all through the Bible. Not that the person lost their salvation, but in a critical time when they need to do what God was telling them to do, they didn't do it. Now, so let's go right now to number one. Just remember Zola and the license plate. Now, what we have here, the ninth month, second day, 1999. Almost 2 years, over 2 years before 9/11. In a dream, I saw a Christian singer, I'm not going to go into who that is, singing in large stadium about the power and glory of America. Many people were there. Horse rides in with clown on it. They take a serious tumble. I'm watching this on TV, start crying. I know America is going to be attacked and destroyed. Now, let me tell you about that dream. It was pomp and circumstance. This stadium was filled with people singing praises to America. This Christian singer was singing praises to America, singing about America. And a horse and a rider came into the stadium, arena, rodeo arena, and it took a terrible fall. And I remember in the dream, everybody had to go, oh! Well, I'm even when I look at this on TV, I went, oh! It was so terrible, you didn't want to look at it. You did not want to look at it. So this is what I'm seeing in TV on the dream. Let's go to number two. Okay, 2 months before 9/11, I dreams about bodies of American people, maybe seven NASA military political, being returned to the United States. I was crying, seemed like overseas, Hawaii, water, skies. And that was the 877th entry in the journal. But in this dream, I dreamed right here. It was much sorrow. I was crying. And I remember overseas, Hawaii, water, NASA, military, political, bodies of America. Well, this is what happened with Colombia when it would burn up over Fort Worth, Texas. February 1st, 2003, about 2 months before we go into Iraq. So even before 9/11 attack, which I have some things in my journals about that, but this specifically, even before the 9/11 attack, the Lord was showing me the shuttle coming down, 7/31/01. Let's go to number three, and I'll tie this all together. 1105-2103. Space shuttle Columbia gone. Blew up over Dallas-Fort Worth. First day, February. Dreams, rider, horse, take hard fall. I'm relating to the old dream. During celebrating America. Now flags at half mast. Many, many days. Left in month. Let's go to number four. A couple of days after that, November 8, the day the shuttle went down, Jose called me from Longhorn Dodge. It's a guy I deal with through the years being here in Fort Worth on vehicles. Said, come get this dump truck. It's cheap, cheap, cheap. I'll give it away to you. I wasn't interested in it. I mean, I use that kind of stuff to work. But it just didn't seem like the time. But the way Jose kept pushing me, he was a Christian. Man, come get this thing. Next thing I know, the Lord provides the money, and I go get the truck. And someone attacks me that God said, it's coming down, shovel. How did and where did God tell me, mocking, the next day? Now, so, let's go back where we were. And so, right before this one, on three, you saw where I had the shovel dream. I need to lay these points out. Let's go to the next one now. As we clean the truck, we see truck tag has shovel on it and rider and horse. The tag came out in 2000, tag made issue, February 2000. Now here's where it starts getting interesting and starts pulling some of this stuff together real tight. Next one. Okay. On that same day, because with all this stuff I write down, I waited on the Lord to quicken me, to tell me to go to my journals and look. And it says, 1110, 2503, I just found my journal. 7/31/01, 684, that's about 7, NASA dead, sad Hawaii. Then underneath that, all of a sudden stuff starts coming together. Confirmed dream, 9/299, horse and the rider, clown coming in and taking a bad fall. And then February 2000 is when the state started issuing the shuttle tags. Let's pull this out if we can, where we can read this. License plate is a sad reminder. Some Texas drivers may have already noticed the irony. Those who haven't eventually will. Since February 2000, the standard Texas license plate issued to more than 10.8 million private vehicles has featured a collage that includes a space shuttle streaking across a starry sky. Okay? Let's go to the next page. Now, 1111-2503, Dream 684, Bodies, American, Hawaii, maybe NASA, 7, Political, Sad. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, here's where it comes out Sunday morning. This is the Sunday morning paper. Pull that up just a little bit more, brother. Go down a little bit. Yes. Yes. The Star Telegram. Space shuttle disintegrates in flames high over Texas. 7 astronauts die. Wreckage hurtles down on wide area. Columbia is lost. Now remember, Columbia, District of Columbia, Washington, D.C. God is speaking in all of this. And remember, I've told you that the judgment for the destruction of the nation has been set. And it was set with the assassination of Rabin. The Lord was saying, this is a sign. Me taking Rabin out. My president, Israel, the apple of my eye. Now you can go to my website and find it. See this dreamer coming. But I had a dream 12 hours before Rabin was assassinated. Wrote it down. Went and told people in the church what I dreamed. And 12 hours later it happened. So it was at that point, a couple of other signs that happened that day, that Sunday when I preached, at the end of the evening when I was walking out the door, and this all ties together. It's all tied together. If you can hear, if you can listen. I heard the Lord speak to my spirit and say, David, if I took the apple of my eye, Rabin, leadership, out, killed him, allowed it to happen, for him giving my land away, what am I going to do to those who twisted his arm behind his back and made him do it? And I said, what, Lord? And he never answered me till 13 years later. 13 years later. I'm sitting watching the report come in that Obama has won the presidency in 08. And it's just really disgusting because if anybody's paying attention and they're not politically correct, they know he's a terrorist. They know he runs around with terrorists. They know his law license, along with his wife's law license, has been stripped away from him for illegal dealings. They know he's a Muslim. They know he goes to a racist church. But we still elect him. So I get up that evening from the chair to go to my office in the house to get it off of my mind. And I go sit down at my desk there and go to looking through the paper. And I come to the back of the paper. And at the back of the paper, down there on the bottom where it gives those birthdays, it says today, November 4th. Is the anniversary of the death, assassination of Rabin 13 years ago. At that very moment, I hear the Lord speak to my spirit and said, David, this is what I do to those who twist the apple of my eye's arm behind his back to give my land away, Obama, Obama Nation. And right now, as we're getting ready to see who's going to be the 2016 president, you think. Obama has divided our nation and tore it apart and gave us away the same way the American government, since Jimmy Carter, has been dividing and giving the land of Israel away and handing them over, trying to hand them over to their enemies, Islam. And Obama, we were turned over to Obama and Islamists, and Obama's been turning the American government and everything about this nation over to Islamists. He's been doing this work. Now let's move on. Next one. Now, this is very important. Can we pull that out of the hair more? Okay. David Stevens. North Texas watched and listened as the space shuttle Columbia broke up and fell to Earth, by David Stevens. Some looked up. There it was. Other Texans heard it. A startling, ominous boom. Remember my dream? Oh, Phil Pita of Fort Worth was reading in bed when the windows of his home began to rattle. Bob Stark of Garland assumed that a tree limb had fallen onto his roof. A Saginaw resident thought that for the second time in a week, a transformer in her neighborhood had exploded. Like others, Beverly Morby ran outside. Let's roll it up just a hair here. On Saturday morning, thousands of Metroplex residents witnessed the heavenly sight of the Space Shuttle Columbia, the bright star of America's space program, streaking like a comet across the clear blue bowl of a lone star sky. Remember, the sky, the blue, Hawaii day, just beautiful. On top of, to get where it got, where it blew up, it had to come across Hawaii to start with. We'll go over that too. David Gibbs stood outside Cattle Barn Number 2 at the Fort Worth Stock Show as a band struck up the Star Spangled Banner. He and veterinarian Dr. Bill Anderson placed their hands over their hearts and squinted against the sun's glare at the brilliant object soaring overhead. Let's run it down. The inspiring sight filled them with patriotic pride. We were just thinking what a treat this was, said Gibbs, the livestock show manager. It's a great morning, the national anthem is playing, and here comes this thing across the sky. The shuttle was traveling at 12,000 miles an hour. Now, here's what we got. The reason that this last one, all the shuttles took off from Florida through the years, but Houston brings them in, okay? During that six-day period, remember, six is the number of man. God's signs are everywhere. He's speaking, if you pay attention. During that 36-year period, during that six-day time period, which is astronomically impossible for it to happen like that, all three disasters, all 17 astronauts die. The last one over Fort Worth, Texas, was flying over top of the Fort Worth Stock Show when it started coming apart. And remember, I saw a Christian singer, somebody singing a patriotic American songs, and then the horse and the rider, the clown on the horse, come riding in and take a terrible fall. Everybody stands, oh! That's what this is talking about. This is nailing it down. Because here's what you have. Here's how you tie this together. Like on the plate, you have the shovel in the sky, and you have the horse and the rider below. You can't beat God. In olden times, the enemy, they rode a horse and a chariot, a horse and a rider. But the shuttle was the horse and the rider, representing the great nation, the shuttle, the horse, and the astronauts, the rider. The Fort Worth Stock Show is the largest, biggest, well-known cowboy cattle event in Texas. This has to do with the Chisholm Trail that went all the way down from South Texas, armor packing meat and all this stuff, all the way up into the north, moving cattle for years and years and years. This is where we get the cowboy from. But God was tying together the cowboy, your great idol, your great strength, I took the horse and the rider down too, but I took the shuttle and the astronaut down. It's tied together in the scriptures. That the horse and rider is thrown into the sea, the enemies of God, and in the verse, even if talking to the big bad nation, it's ruling the world, it's running everything, can't nobody win. Every time you find that among the prophets, God tells them, even if you are so big and bad, you set your nest among the stars. By the way, space station, I will bring you down from your lofty perch. You know Obama, he gave our space station away after he put our shuttles into mothballs. Because remember, he's dividing and tearing down the nation. And this thing ain't over with Mr. Obama yet. Because he's judgment upon this nation. One of the things the Lord showed me about him, the reason he can do what he does it because he ignores protocol. That's his great, that's the magic wand that he has. He ignores protocol, and we let him ignore protocol. But God has allowed it. Now let's go, let me see here. This 12,000 miles an hour. A beautiful thing, said John McNally, president of Central Texas Astronomical Society. The shuttle flashed over the Metroplex. In only 16 minutes, it was scheduled to land in Florida. Amazing. But something happened, a small flash. Suddenly, the shuttle, single vapor contrails became two, three more per place. Andrews lowered his camera. Something looks wrong, he told himself. Let's roll it. Those white chalk marks in the sky, the somber voice TV news reports, the replay after replay soon verified fears and confirmed the horror. The pride of NASA, even if you put your nest among the stars. A marvel of aerospace engineering. But that marvel is not greater than sticking it to Israel and trying to destroy God's firstborn, Israel. Explicitly. Broke into flaming pieces during the final moments of its successful mission, killing its seven astronauts and raining debris from the Metroplex, Fort Worth, Dallas, all the way to Lufkin. Now, do you know where? And because God's always giving signs if you pay attention and listen. Oh, the biggest amount of parts came down in one place, and that's where they set up this warehouse, put this thing back together, and bring all these parts from all over the state of Texas and Louisiana. And it was in Palestine, Texas. God signified again, this has to do with Israel, the land of Israel. Okay, so here we are on number 10. I want to go over some things back to the issue about Zola. Let's blow this up. A note from Zola Levitt after the shuttle disaster 2003. Let's go to where it's marked in red where I can read it. Okay. The course of events. Let me see here. The course of events in the Middle East, even apart from our possible war with Iraq, again, we haven't gone in, has accelerated interest in what, in fact, is at the center of God's prophetic attention. Israel. Now, again, I told you that the Lord took him home because he was messing with that. He was going against the Lord, trying to bless what God was cursing. Let's roll it on down. Let's go down here on the bottom. It says, it says right here, also an honor was my acquaintance with Colonel Rick Husband, commander of the Space Shuttle Columbia, who invited Sandra and me to watch his January 16th shuttle mission blast off. We all mourn the loss of Rick and six others who perished minutes before landing in Florida. Rick was behind our work, and I was, of course, thrilled with the opportunity not only to watch the launch, but also take participate in a church service the day before the blast off. Now let's go back up and read in the center. Rick, a native of Amarillo, Texas, was married. I had two children, a committed believer. He distinguished himself as an ambassador for Christ in the Air Force and at NASA. Though his loss is felt deeply by his family and friends, we are confident that he is now resting beyond the limits of space and heaven itself, commuting face to face. Now remember, face to face there. That's tied. I've had this dream about face to face with Zola, with the Lord. And one day you will all meet this brave American and extraordinary Christian. Providentially, I was asked to speak at Calvary Chapel on Merritt Island to pray a benediction over the launch of the Columbia before it lifted off. Okay. So he says, how do you bless a space voyage? Now, this is the part that he's making. He didn't get from the Lord that he wasn't supposed to bless it. The only biblical event resembling this is in the Exodus, a journey through the unknown and into the promised land. And so I presented Numbers 6:22-25, which states, and the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to Aaron and his son, saying, this is the way you shall bless the children of Israel. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. Only the Lord knew that Rick would indeed be going home to the promised land to be with his Lord. Let's roll it. Let's go over to the side there. Okay, let's roll it down. Okay. Iraqis are saying that it was judgment from God against the United States because of our anticipated war with Saddam Hussein. It was judgment from God. It was judgment from God. There's no doubt about it. But it has to do with what's being done to Israel. Let's roll it. Wherever they discover to be the whatever they discover to be the ultimate cause, we know that this tragedy did not elude the grasp of God. Absolutely. Let's go to the next one. Okay. Number 11. See where we put there? Israel is the big picture. Let's go where it's in red there. It's hard for us to understand the reasons for such catastrophic events, especially concerning something as non-threatening as a scientific advance. Let's face it. There's the face it again. He wasn't facing things, and nothing is non-threatening with God. God knows the ins and outs of everything, motive, intent, and there's certain things that God says just don't do, and one of them is to mess with Israel, and that's what the United States has gotten itself into. Let's roll. Okay, let's go to the next one. Go over and see what we got here. The note, the next one. 12. This is later on after Zola died. He died in 2006. His wife is speaking. Zola has left us, and events for the last few months have caused me to reflect upon some of the places we visited and where he spoke. God's revelation in looking back has been a great comfort to me. I hope to share more with you in the future. Now, she's looking back at things that happened in the past, and that's a comfort to her. I'm looking back at things in the past through the dreams that God's told me was coming, and they came, and that's a comfort to me, knowing that my God is God, and God still speaks to his people who will listen. He doesn't speak to me. Well, that's you. Here we go. Several years ago, Zola and I were in Florida for the launch of a space shuttle Columbia. And remember, Columbia, District of Columbia, Washington, D.C. Columbia is also ISIS. What a thrill to be asked to attend a shuttle rocket launch. Something right out of Buck Rogers. Okay? At the time, because the Israelis had an astronaut going, we thought the Israeli government had invited us. It turned out the commander of the mission, Rick Husband, had invited us. Wow! More than that, Commander Husband had invited Zola to bless the flight. There it is, y'all. Bless the flight. See, God showed me. Remember? 99, like 7/21/99 or something, the very first one. It was coming down. The horse and the rider. Then the next one, 2 months before the 9/11 attack, literally the shuttle coming down. The night before the launch, each family had some kind of reception for the guest. Commander Husband's was in a church. Most of the other receptions were in hotels. But Commander Husband was a man of great belief. Zola even wore his tallit. Prayer shawl, let's roll it. This is a roundabout way of saying it was quite a celebration for the launch. A famous Christian singer. See, I had a dream that a famous Christian singer was there. Okay? Now, it's not the same Christian singer as this that I saw. But the point was being made about a Christian singer. I wouldn't have known who this was. Understand? I would not have known who this person was. But I knew it was a famous Christian singer. Singer was there, and we met Commander Husband's family. It was funny in a way because they were making such a fuss over Zola. Everyone was so excited to meet him, and here we were with astronauts, and we were so excited to meet him. It was quite a love-in, I must say. Zola's message was about new frontiers and how the children of God went on a new adventure, Exodus. Now, this is important because the Exodus is not going to be about the amount they wind up exiting from the spaceship into heaven to stand before God, the people who died. But this is about the American Exodus that's coming out of this nation behind the destruction of this nation. This is what's coming. When they came out of Egypt, all the time trusting God, he spoke of embarking on a new life, one full of new discoveries. It was such a beautiful message. I did not realize at the time just how much of a new life the Columbia crew was going to have. Let's roll it down. Okay, so again, I just want to point out to you, the Lord had showed me that Columbia was not blessed. He was bringing, see, somebody said, well, what's the purpose if after it's over, you got all this information? Well, first of all, it proves the judgment is set. That's what the Lord has shown. It's set. It's just to prove that there's no surprise. It's like the book of Revelation. You look at it, we win as Christians. You look at the book of Revelation, it looks all out of control. But it's so in control, God had it wrote down by John exactly what's going to happen. All the uncontrol is so under control, it's written down by the man of God. It's not out of control to his people. God has it. It's going just the way he wants it to go. But he does make that point in Revelation, do not take or add to. And when Zola goes to bless this thing, he's not getting the leadership from the Lord to do it. And at some point, I can hear some people say, well, David Donovan, what right do you have to say this, that God did that? Well, because God showed me that, told me that. Well, you're nobody. Well, he is neither. Nobody is. Jesus is Lord. And that's where most of us have our problems, and that's why we don't hear from the Lord anyway, because we think we are somebody. I'm somebody to God, and that's good enough. Let's go on to the next one. 13 now. Watch this. I got all this stuff written down, okay? Pay attention. 4 or 5 years later, August 25th, 2010, 36-37, Steve Miller saw Caleb, his son. They're mocking. That's what I'm told by Steve. That people don't believe this stuff. But at some point, Steve said, Caleb said, I know God told Pastor David about the space shuttle. He was a young boy, and at this time he's a Marine. And they heard this in the church before it ever happened. Some godly fear, okay? And I'm praising God as pastor, hearing this godly fear in this young man, you know? Whatever he's struggling with, he knows what he knows. And so Steve leaves to go get bread for me at the store. He brings back a space shuttle bread complete with Stars and stripes, here we go, Psalms 32:8. I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go, and I will guide you with mine eye. The point being is, all this time later, Steve hasn't seen this boy for a while since he's been in the Marines. He sees the boy, he comes to see me, and he brings this up. Well, you know, it's tough, hard to believe. Caleb said, look, Daddy, I know one thing, whatever I think about whatever, I know that space shuttle thing was right. So he leaves to go get me a loaf of bread. And all these years later, he walks in and pulls that loaf of bread and pulls out. He didn't even see it. He brings it to me. I go, Steve, what's this? And you're looking at it. It's about the very thing we're talking about. See, God does move like that. God does, some people that call it, he quickens me, or he, you know, but this means something. It's all about timing. Let's roll it. Next one. I'll show you. Let's blow it up. There it is. The shuttle, 1981 to 2010. Obama gets in office. Obama gets in office. See right there, it's even stamped. By August 30th, used by 210. Okay? Obama gets in office and shuts the space shuttle program down. Puts them in mothballs. Then he gives the keys to the space station to Russia. Lord, just reminding again, David, I'm doing this. Let's roll it. Next one. Miss Barrett's bread, 15. NASA space shuttle program, 1981 to 2010. Nothing lasts forever but God. Let me look at the rest of the paper there. Roll it up. No, the one I was just on. Let me look at it better at the bottom there. See if we missed anything. Roll it up. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, let's see what else we got, bro. All righty, here we go. Let's blow this up. So, see, now look what we got. We got the space station up at the top. Look at the very top. There they are. They're out of it, like with the space station, the shuttle hooking up with the space station. I mean, they're outside the shuttle, all that old stuff. You know, let's blow it up and see what the bread says. Miss Baird's bread. Now, another thing, what's interesting about Miss Baird's bread, see, this is about the Jews. This is about Israel. This is about giving away Jerusalem. And bread, it's about the house of bread. Bethlehem, where David was from. Bethlehem, house of bread. What else we got here? Let me roll this, look more at this, see if we got something. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Miss Baird's 1981-2010 shuttle program. Miss Baird's has been baking business for 73 years. When NASA space shuttle program lost its first manned shuttle April 12, 1981, today as well as then, Miss Baird's is dedicated to using precious ingredients, time-tested baking techniques to produce quality, delicious baked breads. Miss Baird salutes the space shuttle crews and thousands of men and women who made the space shuttle program an important part of our country's history. Enter for a chance to win a trip to Space Center Houston. View the launch of Discovery Shuttle from Kennedy Space Center, Florida, scheduled for September 16, 2010. See Miss Baird's for details and complete rules. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited. Now look at it. It says at the bottom. Roll that up. Make it bigger there. All U.S. space flights have been launched from Kennedy Space Center, Florida. Okay? All of them came out of Florida. Let's go to the next one, 18. Okay, here we are back here again on this, and we'll close on this. You got to understand, just go to your concordance and look up Miriam, when the Israelites cross, the Red Sea's open, they get across, and the river goes back in over the Egyptians, and Miriam and the ladies grab their tambourines and start singing, the horse and rider are thrown into the sea. That is the cowboy there, okay? But that is also the shuttle in the air with the astronauts. The verse says to the Big Bad Nation, Jeremiah, you can find it in most of the prophets, the major prophets, If this Big Bad Nation, if you set your nest among the stars, I will bring you down from your lofty perch Now, what you have in that space shuttle on the left up there, among the stars, got it? And over to the right, you've got the crescent moon. The very enemy that America's tried to give Israel to is the one we have been given to. Now, here's something else very important about this tag. When I decided to do my first video on this, a few years after, I'd written all this down. I went to the Texas Tag site, and they showed all the designs of the tags all the way back to when Tags for Texas first started. Sometimes they go a year, sometimes they go 10 years, sometimes longer. And they had a tag for each year. This tag, that number is the one that was up on the site, the 666. And again, I'm tying this for you that the big and the bad is Texas. The cowboy, the power, the oil, the space program. Texas is a target. It is the main target. After those twin towers, the money, the power of New York, Texas is the target of the Islamists. And this is where they plan on hitting and hitting big, because the Lord has showed this to me in dreams and visions. And it's just a matter of time till this goes down. God is bringing the nation down. And what's going to happen? Some are going to die by the sword. Some are going to die by pestilence. Others are going to be allowed to leave here. We're at the end, about the time for Christ to come. And we know that the Jews have to go home. And that right now there's more Jews, or as many Jews in America as there is in Israel right now. So something had to happen to make them leave and get out of here. But again, let me just make this, and you check it for yourself. All three shuttles were destroyed in the 6-day period, February 27th to February 1st, in a 36-year period. And that's because at that time the Fort Worth Stock Show was going on, and that was the last week of it. And the Lord was tying both events together to get us to see and understand that God is bringing the high and the mighty down. Because when you go to try to bring Israel down, and he's God's firstborn, I don't care how big you are, you will go down before Israel will. And America is reaping on itself what it set Israel up for. Jesus is Lord. Thank you for watching this.